Hey, welcome back, fellow scientists. It's Justin again. I know. I was supposed to be going on a road trip around Florida, not flying, but there's a rocket launch happening later today at the Kennedy Space Center, and we wanted to make sure we did not miss that. And anyway, what better place is there to learn about aerospace engineering? The science of flight. Oh, where's Mia? Well, she got upgraded to first class, but don't worry, we'll see her when we land. I didn't get up. It's fine. By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to describe how aerospace engineers design, test, and build the aircraft and spacecraft that take us from the ground to the stars. Buckle up and let's get into it. With around 45,000 flights crisscrossing the skies of the United States every day, and nearly 10,000 satellites orbiting above us, aerospace engineers have a big job. But what is aerospace engineering? Aerospace engineering is the field of science that gets us flying in the sky and exploring outer space. It can be broken down into two branches, aeronautics and astronautics. Aeronautical engineering focuses on designing, building, and testing aircraft that operate within Earth's atmosphere. And it's not just about airplanes. Aeronautical engineers work on helicopters, drones, and just about anything that flies through the air. Sending humans into flight isn't something that happened overnight. People dreamed of soaring like a bird for ages before it became a reality. Thousands of years ago, the ancient Greeks were fascinated by the idea of flight. They told stories of Icarus, who built wings out of feathers and wax. When he flew too close to the sun, the wax melted and he fell into the sea. While just a myth, it shows how deeply rooted the dream of flight is in human history. Fast forward to the 1400s, when our favorite artist and inventor, Leonardo da Vinci, studied birds to design plans for flying machines that would allow humans to take to the sky. But it wasn't until 1903 when the Wright brothers, Orville and Wilbur, built the world's first successful powered airplane. After years of trial and error, their plane stayed aloft for 12 whole seconds. Wow. It might not sound like a long time, but this achievement paved the way for modern aeronautics. Since then, aeronautical engineers have made huge advancements in flight. In the same 5 hours it would take to drive across the city of Los Angeles, an airplane can fly passengers all the way to Washington, D.C. Helicopters can hover and move in any direction, making them perfect for rescue missions and flying to hard-to-reach places. And jets can travel at speeds faster than the speed of sound. But how do you think planes actually fly? Pause the video and record your thoughts in your guided notes. Flight is all about a few key forces, lift and thrust. Lift is created by the wings of the plane. The wings are specially shaped with a curved top surface and a flatter bottom surface. This design causes the air to move faster over the top of the wing and slower underneath. This difference in airspeed pushes the plane up. Lift. Thrust is provided by the engines, whose force pushes the plane forward. When the lift from the wings is greater than the weight pulling the plane down, and the thrust from the engines is greater than the air slowing the plane down, the plane takes off and flies. Understanding these forces is essential for aeronautical engineers. By continuously innovating, testing, and refining their designs, they can make flight safer and more efficient, keeping us soaring higher and farther. Ooh, it looks like we've landed. Let's go meet up with Mia so we can head to the rocket launch. Hey Mia, ready for the next part of our adventure? Now that we've covered aeronautics, it's time to blast off into astronautical engineering. which is all about exploring beyond our planet. Exactly, Amiya. Aeronautics laid the foundation for astronautics. All we learned about flight within Earth's atmosphere helped us develop the technology to reach to space. Astronautical engineering is the branch of engineering that focuses on designing, building, and testing spacecraft. This includes rockets, satellites, space stations, and any technology used for space exploration. Space travel is truly incredible. Did you know that humans can travel to the moon faster than it takes a ship to cross the Atlantic Ocean? That's the power of astronautical engineering at work. Wow, you look ready for the moon, Mia. Accomplishing such a huge feat takes a lot of work. Astronautical engineers have to solve really challenging problems in order to build successful spacecraft. What types of problems do you think they face? Record your thoughts in your guided notes. Well, their designs have to be powerful enough to escape Earth's gravity, strong enough to withstand the harsh environment of space, and reliable enough to keep astronauts safe and healthy for extended periods of time. These are exactly the types of problems astronautical engineers had to solve during the Apollo program, the missions that first put humans on the moon. One of their biggest challenges was designing the lunar module. The materials had to be strong enough to protect the astronauts from the extreme temperatures and radiation levels of space. But they also had to be lightweight enough that the module could get to the moon with enough fuel to get back. One major design challenge was designing the lunar module's landing legs. They had to absorb the huge impact of landing on the moon's rocky and uneven surface. Through the engineering design process, the astronautical engineers tackled the problem step by step. The first leg design was simple and straightforward, but it didn't absorb enough force for the astronauts to land safely. So in the next design, the engineers incorporated shock absorbers. This solution was more stable, but now the legs were way too heavy. Finally, engineers came up with a design that included a collapsible honeycomb structure inside the legs. This design was lightweight and effectively absorbed the landing impact. With tons of testing, this final design proved to be mission ready. After countless trials and refinements, the Apollo 11 mission landed successfully on the moon in 1969. The journey from the initial design to the final build of the lunar module shows the importance of the engineering design process and the incredible problem-solving skills of the astronautical engineers. Since then, astronautical engineers have made huge strides in space exploration, and the future looks even more exciting. Engineers are now working on new challenges, like designing spacecraft that can take humans to Mars and beyond. New satellites and telescopes are helping us to learn about galaxies beyond the Milky Way and to monitor the health of the Earth. The work of astronautical engineers ensures we continue to reach for the stars. And we can see that for ourselves. We've reached the Kennedy Space Center, where a new satellite is being launched today. Ooh, and it looks like they're about to start. Quick, before the countdown, let's review everything we've learned today. Aerospace engineering is divided into two branches. Aeronautical engineers work on aircraft that fly within our atmosphere, and astronautical engineers work on spacecraft that fly outside of it. Both types of engineers design, build, and test the crafts so they're as safe and efficient as possible. To learn more about aerospace engineering, be sure to check out the activities and practice questions that go with this lesson. Wow. That watch was awesome! And it's even more amazing knowing how much work went into making it possible. We'll see you soon as we continue our engineering road trip. And remember, scientists, curiosity is the architect of discovery. See you next time! Hey, hey.